the Lee Steinberg event at Super Bowl 2017. Earlier, we were at the Global Brain Division at the seminar, and Elizabeth ran the panel. Elizabeth, tell us, why is it so important for people to know? You said 85% of the people do not understand concussion. How do you think you can get the word out, and tell us why that's so important?
I think by increasing awareness in a number of different groups of people. So we talked a little bit today about the veterans, about no other military, active duty military, but also about athletes and other people like that. And so I think by increasing awareness, that's the one thing that we can do to sort of promote awareness and research.
So tell us how you got involved in your history about who you are and how you got to where you are.
So I'm a neuropsychologist by training. I work at Baylor College of Medicine and at the Michael E. DeBakey VA. And I've been involved in research in this area for about 20 years.
Wow.
So, concussion has become a more recent focus. Before that, the focus was much more on severe, moderate to severe TBI. But been very happy to be involved in concussion research as well.
Right. So what is the newest technology that is that's available now, and what do you see that's coming in the
advanced techniques to be able to better detect and diagnose, as well as monitor and evaluate treatments in TBI?
And what's coming up in the future here? Like, if I was a mom, oh, what is that?
Glad you brought your hair.
So you just never know when a big guy's going to get connected to you. That's live TV. We love it. So if you're a mom and you have a child, what are the things that you're going to the doctor? I've been there myself with a son who got a concussion. And you don't know if you have a good doctor or up on technology. What should you be looking for, asking for your child when you show up at that medical facility?
So I think the most important thing is a really good physical exam. I'm making sure that everybody's sort of asking all of the questions and evaluating the patient. Oftentimes they'll do a CT exam, the head, an imaging exam.
Okay.
Sometimes it's necessary to do more than that in terms of imaging, and sometimes not. But I think really the most important thing is a very thorough discussion about what happened and a discussion about the symptoms that a mom needs to look for, that may happen immediately but may also be happening over time.
Good advice to know what the symptoms to look for that could be happening that you might not be aware of. And yet when I went there, I was so, I thought the testing was so minor. They had a baseline, but they really just asked my son a lot of questions, and did like a little test on him, like, count these numbers. And it was like an academic type test. And I was like, really? That's all you're going to do is that? That's it? How do you determine it from that? So I felt like there should have been something more scientific than this written test. And they did have him stand on one foot to see if you had your balance. So I guess that's what I'm asking. Is there something else, like, should they be taking blood work? Should they be doing something like, just more technical?
Yeah, unfortunately, there's a lot of things that are under development, but they're still very much in the research space. And I think what we need to do is work on all of those tools to get them to the point where we can use them in clinical practice and at an individual level. So I think there are a lot of things in process, but not yet available in the clinic, unfortunately.
And that's why we need more research and more dollars to help support the whole thing.
Absolutely.
And it's great to have events like this that help bring awareness and let everyone know what's going on and seeing what's in the forefront of brain technology. This is Melanie Johnson at Super Bowl 2017 at the Lee Steinberg event. Always something new. Keep watching. We got more coming.
All right.